Let's go. Okay, thanks a lot for coming tonight. That will be the introductory talk for the WebAssembly night. It's not often that we have thematic meetups at Paris.js, so let's enjoy that. My name is Vladimir de Turquem. I handle everything related to Node.js in a Parisian really cool security startup named Screen. There is even another screener in the room. So if you're interested in what we do, feel free to talk to us. We do security monitoring. Runtime protection, please follow me on Twitter. I'm trying to beat my CEO at the follower account. So the topic tonight is WebAssembly, and actually the question is but what is WebAssembly? And before telling you what is WebAssembly, I need to explain you what is the problem that led to WebAssembly. So at the beginning, you want to run code in a web browser. So you can use JavaScript. It's true, JavaScript run in web browsers. But then you want to have visibility about the memory regarding the memory consumption of your code. So in JavaScript, that's false. Okay. But then you want to prevent people from reading your source code in the browser. So I put the empty string because the empty string has the falsy value in JavaScript. So it means false. And then you want to reuse C libraries in the browser. I put null because null also has the falsy value in JavaScript. I want to have predictable performances. So zero, yes, once again, zero has a falsy value in JavaScript. And I want real falsy values. I don't want anything being falsy or truthy, and not a number. That's still not true, and that's still something that is falsy in JavaScript. So, yes, so the people at Mozilla and me figured out it was a bit lame in terms of feature for JavaScript, for a real programming language. So don't take everything for granted. I love JavaScript, it's my favorite language in the world with Java, but I just had to learn the script part to move from one to the other. So. But those people at Mozilla, they said JavaScript... does not provide us with the professional grade level programming language we are expecting for the web. It was cool for 20 years, but let's do something serious. So let's fix that. Let's find a solution to run code in a browser following the constraint we detailed previously. And they created something named ASM.js. And ASM.js, it's a subset of JavaScript. So, it's a subset of JavaScript that is smaller than JavaScript as a language, and you can take C or C++ code and compile it to ASM.js. Okay, and it can run on any JavaScript engine because it's JavaScript. It's a subset of the JavaScript language. It looks like that. As you can see, it's just pure JavaScript code. It's ugly and nobody wants to write, or even worse, read that, but it's totally valid JavaScript with somehow native type. You see, they use a pipe to prevent variables to be something else than an integer. That's some JavaScript secret. Or they tweet bits or things like that. And basically, the goal from Firefox was, let's have this subset of JavaScript and let's optimize our JavaScript engine for executing that kind of code. So there were even, you remember, the use strict use in JavaScript. You could use ASM in a string to tell the JavaScript runtime that you were writing ASM.js and to optimize the code for ASM. And then all these people were like, yeah, ASM, it's a good idea, but we want a binary format. Because it's still JavaScript, it's still plain text code, and they wanted a binary format that would be more efficient, smaller, and easier to to have through the network. So they all went together. It was that's basically a miracle for the world of the internet. If you remember the two great wars of the web browsers, you know how hard it is to have these people talk to each other. And they decided to create a new standard named WebAssembly, and they did that directly with the W3C that is in charge of the web standards, including HTML and CSS. So there's something cool with WASM, with WebAssembly. It's a binary format, and you can compile pretty much from everything you want to WebAssembly. So obviously C++ using Unscripten, Rust, but let's not spoil too much the next talks. Or another thing I love that is not really well known, that's known assembly script. It's basically a subset of TypeScript that compiles to WebAssembly. So for the 2 or 4 billion people who actually love TypeScript because it's very popular, for the metric like 60% of people using NPM actually use TypeScript, you can write some TypeScript and compile that to WebAssembly. It's still not silver bullet and still under dev, but it's a very nice language. Woo! And what does TypeScript look like? It looks like that. And basically, so there is a bijection between the binary format and what we call WAT, WebAssembly text. That is a text human readable format. Yeah, I know. The human readable format. And you can see that you've got typing in TypeScript like integer 32, so it's integer 32 bytes. You even have functions that can be defined. You can import things from JavaScript or even export things to JavaScript. It's an assembly, but it's not a very low-level assembly. It's a smart assembly that could be considered as smart as not as smart as the Java bytecode, but still pretty smart. Basically, what you can do with WebAssembly is call WebAssembly function from JavaScript, if they are exported, or call JavaScript function from WASM, if they are bound to the WASM executable, but you don't have access to the DOM. You don't have access to window or document from WASM. WASM is some kind of sandbox. You need to bind the thing you want to access from WASM, or you need to export the thing you want to access from WASM to JavaScript. So the question everyone asks, is it fast? Because remember, that was one of the goals, having a predictable performance in the browser. And actually, it's pretty fast. So that's a numeric operation, that's a Fibonacci computing. And that's the number of Fibonacci number you can compute in 1 second. So on the left-hand side, you've got pure JavaScript, then assembly script compiled to WebAssembly, and then Rust compiled to WebAssembly. And that we can see that Rust is blazing faster than anything else, and even assembly script is faster than JavaScript. So yes, WebAssembly is blazing fast. But I mean, I know you like to compute Fibonacci numbers, but you might have real use case. And in the web, real use case, it's strings. I mean, it's string manipulation. DOM manipulation, it's string. Input manipulation, it's string. And I've been doing string operations. This one is looking up for substring in a string. And JavaScript is way faster than assembly script. It is way faster than Rust. Compile to WebAssembly. So that's a bit unexpected and ununderstandable. So maybe there's something we don't understand yet. So let's ask the question, how do we make a JavaScript string available in a WebAssembly bundle? And something I haven't told you yet is that when you do WebAssembly, you provide a WebAssembly memory object. That is basically a buffer, a numeric buffer, with a given size, and you write the memory into it. And the WebAssembly bundle has internally a memory management algorithm. So when you bundle some WebAssembly, you need to ship it with a memory management algorithm. So the question is, I have a JS string, hello, I want to make it available to a WebAssembly function inside my WebAssembly bundle. So here we've got the memory object. That's basically, as I told you, an array buffer on which you can have diverse views based on the typing of the items you want in the view. But that's always numerical. That's integer, unsigned integer, undiverse number of memory size. So the goal here is to write HELLO in an array buffer. So I write it in ASCII. And I make it available this way to my WebAssembly code. Once again, there is no memory management, so if I want to write it in the buffer, I first need to know where to write it in a buffer. So I need
to ask the equivalent of a malloc, of a memory allocation. So I will first call a function exposed by the WebAssembly bundle to tell the WebAssembly bundle, hey, dear WebAssembly bundle, how are you doing today? I would like to write something that will have a length of this number of elements in the array buffer. Please give me a starting pointer. So you do that. So you do a first call to the WebAssembly bundle from JavaScript, and it returns just an integer that is an index in the shared array buffer you will use. Then you need to loop on your string to get the ASCII code and to write it character by character in this part of the array buffer where you are allowed to write, and you should not write somewhere else, otherwise you will corrupt the memory of the WebAssembly process. And basically, that is what is long when you want to do some interesting things in WebAssembly. If you want to provide, to exchange numbers between WebAssembly and JavaScript, that's totally native and that's totally fast. So if you want to do matrix calculation, it can be somehow fast. That's why you can use that for pre-rendering 3D things. But if you want to manipulate strings in WebAssembly, basically, you're a bit screwed at this point. Does that mean WebAssembly should not be used and we should cancel this meetup right now and go to pizza and beer right now? First of all, it's way too hot for pizzas. Secondly, they are not delivered yet. So, let's save the day and say there might be a solution. What would be cool would be to be able to have a JavaScript string available directly in WebAssembly. Could we share the memory space directly from the engine, from JavaScript to WebAssembly? We could, but what happens if the WebAssembly bundle, remember, it's probably C or C++, call a free on the memory chunk where your string is decides to release the memory chunk. I know it's a bit philosophical, but in JavaScript, either you have a pointer to something, either nobody has a pointer, and it will be garbage collected. There is no null pointer. Either you have a pointer to something, either nobody has a pointer to this thing, and it gets garbage collected. So what would happen if WASM free the string from JavaScript side? And actually, that will break the world. And please don't break the internet. I mean, we did that with LeftPad already. Let's not do that too many times. Hopefully, there is a solution that will be probably available by the end of the year or beginning of next year. It's called weak references. And actually, that's the upcoming feature of JavaScript I'm the most excited about in the whole world. Because of weird fantasies. But the point of this one is, I will be able to take a weak reference on an object. So, I take a string, hello world, and instead of doing string equals hello world, I do ref string equals new weak reference hello world. Meaning that what is in the ref str variable is not a pointer, is not a reference to the string, it's a reference to some kind of proxy object that has a method named namestrong. Maybe it will be called deref, it's not finalized yet. And namestrong can return two things. Either it will return the string, if it still exists, either it will return undefined, if the string has been garbage collected or freed. Meaning, if you want to manipulate the string at this point, you need to check if it's undefined or a string for real. But the interest is that you would be able to have memory objects that are available in WebAssembly, that could be freed by WebAssembly, memory managed by WebAssembly, without breaking your JavaScript code, except if you forget to check if it's undefined or not. It's called the future, and I'm sure the future talks, the two next talks, will explain that way better in practice. Thanks so much for your attention. If you have questions, you can answer them, but I will reserve the right to the next speaker to say no spoiler. Given my great accent, I think everyone knows I speak. Alors, merci pour cette question. Oui, il y a. Alors, bien sûr, il y a Node. Of course, there is Node.js. So the question is, can we run WebAssembly outside of a web browser? Of course, there is Node.js. But there is another tool, another project named Wasmer, that is basically using WebAssembly format as a universal binary format. Like, you would have a WebAssembly bundle and just run it natively from any desktop machine or server. I remember Solomon, the former CTO and co-founder of Docker, telling, if Wasmer had existed 10 years ago, we would have never built Docker. To tell you how exciting this project is. So yeah, basically, that can be used as a universal format. Les weak références?
Ouais, la mémoire, en fait, du coup, elle est où? Comment elle est partagée? Enfin, comment... elle est où cette mémoire?
Alors, je la fais en français, parce que sinon, j'ai me perdre. T'as ton string, il existe à un endroit. Il y a un certain nombre de références qui pointent dessus. Lui, il existe à un endroit qui va être défini par l'aspect d'interaction WebAssembly JavaScript. Et globalement, ils vont dire c'est un string JavaScript et à WebAssembly de se démerder pour le lire. Il va exister dans la heap de ton process actuel, donc de ton tab dans Chrome ou de ton process node si tu es en node. C'était ça ta question ou...
Bah, c'est plutôt en fait, pour moi c'est pas très clair en fait de lire la mémoire. C'est juste que je vois bien comment ça marche WebAssembly, ce genre. Au début tu vois, t'as mis ton exec, t'as toute la mémoire dedans. Là ce que tu montres c'est que grosso modo il y a la mémoire qui est allouée niveau JS.
Ouais.
T'as la mémoire qui est envoyée en fait côté Assembly. Et alors, du coup, t'as, côté WebAssembly, t'as une stack, t'as aussi plein de trucs.
Alors côté WebAssembly, t'as vraiment juste ton bandeau de mémoire.
Donc du coup c'est copié dedans.
Et ben lui il va lui partager un pointeur et l'autoriser à communiquer avec de la mémoire externe. On va perdre la partie sandbox de WebAssembly quand on fait ça.
Ah ok, d'accord. Donc ça viole la c'est ça.
Alors de ce que j'ai compris, on va le mettre dans un espace de mémoire partagé qui ne sera pas nécessairement l'espace JS, qui ne sera pas nécessairement l'espace WebAssembly, qui sera un espace hybride entre les deux. Mais c'est encore under spec pour cette partie-là. Parce qu'en fait, c'est assez intéressant. Parce que WebAssembly, c'est défini par le W3C. Et ça, c'est défini par le TC39, qui définit JavaScript. Du coup, on est sur deux specs qui viennent de deux organismes différents, un étant un consortium d'entreprises, l'autre étant un organisme de standardisation européen. Et donc, ils sont en train un peu de se courir derrière pour savoir qui va finir sa spec en premier, pour savoir qui va imposer à l'autre le système de partage. D'ailleurs, par exemple, ils veulent même mettre un système de garbage collection optionnel disponible pour tous les process WebAssembly. That's a very good question. So I'm using the native, and actually there is a... I will do a side note on a native call from JavaScript. Actually, calling native method in C++ from JavaScript, even in V8, is extremely expensive. That's why the V8 team created a new language named Torquay that basically compiles to V8 bytecode so they don't have to leave JS land. So I did that before the optimization, so we still have the cost of going to C-Land that is more expensive than going to Torquay. But that's a good question, but given the order of magnitude, it's still... Yeah, at this point. But you have a cost of binding from JavaScript to C when you call it in an older version of V8. But, for instance, in WebAssembly, in Rust, I was calling the native substring method from Rust.
Il y avait une question juste derrière.
Yes.
So, what happens to the benchmark
when you try weak references and the creating? Weak references are not available yet.
Oh. and so, if they're not available, can you choose not to call it undefined, but undefined? That would make no sense.
I mean, just show up to the repo and check if the discussion already happened. I don't know. It's TC39 specs. I have no great opinion on that topic.
Il y avait, je crois, une autre question encore derrière.
I got your question. So actually, you decide, because you've got the WebAssembly memory object, and you could bound that to two WebAssembly bundles. I'm not sure they would understand what is in the memory, because they come with their own memory algorithm, memory management algorithm. But since this object is manipulated JavaScript side, you could bound it to two different WebAssembly bundles. If they have the same memory management algorithm, meaning if you have compiled them with the same version of LMScripten and the same version of C, probably. Okay. But I would not recommend doing that between Rust and C, for instance. Yeah.
Okay. On va prendre une dernière question, s'il vous plaît.
That's a good question. I had the question last year and I checked and I said yes, but it was last year, so I can just say I think last year I said yes. That was equivalent.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, thank you very much.